think it's really cinematic when it comes to that B-roll, but the beautiful souls, beautiful world, welcome back to my YouTube channel. And if you remember correctly, there's always a shot in the previous vlogs, like me talking in the car or driving around the town, or the vlog itself start in the car. I really miss those days. I really miss that vibes, vlogging, driving vibe. Although it wasn't really the best or great or even the good vlogs back I did it at that time. Maybe a few years later, if I do something crazy like in name of vlog, then I look back at this vlog here and I say, it's total garbage. But that's not why I'm here. Now, when you read the title, why SUV, you may think I'm going to talk about my EcoSport here, why I bought this SUV or why SUV, why I chose it, or generally why SUVs here. Well, not talking about cars here because I'm a huge film nerd, hope you guys know, especially Hollywood movies. I am fascinated about the movie name selections like NGK, KGF. These short names have more depth meaning. It represents the entire movie. So I want to make the entire vlog title short, which means a lot in it. So what I refer to SUV here is, should you vlog? It's a huge question. Whether you got a YouTube channel or you want to start a YouTube channel, a lot of people asking to themselves and other people, why should I vlog? So let me put this way, there's nothing like you should vlog or you must vlog or you can vlog, or say there's nothing like what you should vlog or what I can vlog or what you must vlog. It completely depends upon you. You can vlog, or you don't have to vlog. If you want to vlog, what should I vlog? It's completely up to you. There's nothing like a specific content you can choose. There's infinite content out there. Now these days, a lot of people are concentrating on health and training and all that. Some people are focusing on food, travel. There are other people share personal life, their tutorial vlogs. There's a lot of content. So how can you be differ from one another is the question, and why should you vlog is a question. Let me say this from my perspective or my understanding, why I love vlogging and why I want to watch vlogs. So before I'll say why I love vlogging, let me put it this way. The first thing you should do when you start a channel is be you. If you look at my previous vlog, I never tried to be the vlogger. I tried to be that vlogger because I was always trying to imitate or try to adapt somebody else's skill and try to make vlogs. I never tried to be the vlogger. I never understand me, why I should do all these things or what should I do with my vlogs. So be you is the important thing when you start with vlogging, or is the basis of vlogging, which leads to why I love vlogging and why I'm doing this. I have a certain specific to this channel. That's why I'm doing the way that I'm doing right now, certain goals and purpose to it. Let me put it this way. When I do vlogs, I'm improving my camera skills and editing skills each vlog after vlog. So I'm a huge film nerd. I want to be an actor, but who knows what world throws at you in the name of opportunity. One day somebody approaches me to, you know, do the entire cinematography for their film or edit their film. It's a good chance of getting to where I want to be, right? So if you want to be a filmmaker or something like that, if you start vlogging or if you do vlogging, it's the best, you create this best space to improve your camera skills and editing skills. So let's say I don't want to be a filmmaker, I want to entertain people, or I want to have some joy with my life or experience, or no, the footage itself. Still, you can do that, which leads to the most important part, why I love vlogging and why I prefer vlogging. It's because I can learn something from your experience through your video when you put up there. And when I hit the subscribe button, I include you guys as a part of me. I'm learning more and more. This is my perspective to life. If you think like a monk, every life is a possibility. All we are doing is we chose to be good or bad, chose to be the best or the worst. That's what we're doing as human beings. But if you think every life is a possibility, you can learn at least a thing from every human being out there. Doesn't matter if that person is elder than you or older than you. You can learn something from each individual. Which leads to another most important question a lot of people ask. What kind of camera gears or camera should I use? I'll say there are a lot of people who can afford expensive cameras and gears, or let me put it this way, this camera I'm using right now is around $1,000 camera. Sorry, a huge Hollywood net, always think like that. This costs more than 1 lakh, including the extra lens and gear that I'm using, so it's not affordable, super affordable. But I never thought I'm going to vlog with this camera here. Then let's say some people can't even afford a camera, still you can use vlogging through your phone. And there's nothing like you should use a camera or you should use a software, computer software. You can still use to shoot and edit in phone itself. There's a lot of options out there. Technology is growing, everything is changing and different. When I started vlogging, I don't even use camera. I use 1 MB front camera for my old iPhone, which definitely make a lot of difference, but there's all it matters is your skills. The camera, behind camera skills and how you tell the story. That's it. So this happened yesterday. One of my friends started a YouTube channel. He posted the very first video yesterday. Go check it out, link in bio. Link in the description, go check it out. Before that, he asked me to edit his video and I said no to him. He became upset or angry, whatever. No, just chatting. Then after posting the video, I got to his messenger and I texted that, congratulations bro, welcome to YouTube community and all that. And I said, the reason why I didn't edit your video is because if I do that, I leave my identity in your video, in your vlog. But if you do it yourself, then you are the one who's controlling everything. The best way to put videos out there is completely do it your own, and you leave your identity without messing anybody else's. If you need a pair of hands to help shoot you, then you call your friend or somebody who's capable of handling cameras. But editing and all that is completely up to you. You leave an identity when you post each vlogs. Then one of the other questions a lot of people come in their mind, including me, what my audience wants. And let me put it this way, never think about your audience or what they want. What you want matters the most with your channel. I heard this literally yesterday. I heard this from a very good YouTuber that I used to watch videos. Link in bio, he's telling about how to make your YouTube channel successful. I was checking into it, link down below, go check it out. Very useful, helpful. He was explaining a lot of tips to grow your channel. One of them was never think about what your audience wants. Always do what you want. They will come to you. Because if you focus on certain audience, you will stick with that. You're never gonna improve much, or you're never gonna possibly grow much. You stay in a sustained way. That's not what you want. Well, that's not what you want, isn't it? You want to grow your channel. So never think about your audience or what they want. Go for what you want. Then the other most important part of YouTube channel, never focus on money and fame. That happened to a very few lucky people out there. So don't focus on that. Just get out there, shoot with whatever you got. Skill matters, your talent matters the most. Do it and you will become successful on YouTube. Enjoy the process, editing, filming, editing, and posting videos. You'll become successful. But don't just focus on money and fame, all that, because if that's the goal, then probably you're gonna fail. So before closing today's video, I wanna give a small shout out to my dear friends who recently started their YouTube channel. 1 minute, I gotta take my phone because sometimes I mess up the channel's name. First of all, big shout out to Voss Vlogger. Woo's Vlogger. I'm sorry man, I just messed up your channel's name, but he's one of my best friends around. He's doing great with the channel. He also reacted to one of my TikTok, very viral TikTok video that I'd done last year. RIP TikTok. It's a great tragedy. So one of my other friends recently started a YouTube channel. Her channel's name is Happy Moments with Anna. Good luck, Anna. You just started nice, so Go post more videos. I'll always be there with support. Go check it out, guys, and support and love. Show some love to her. Which leads to the final person I just mentioned earlier in this vlog, Sudish. His channel's name is Only Bark No Bite. So basically he's focusing on dogs and dog training. Probably he just posted one video. By the time you watch this video, probably there are gonna be more videos in his channel. So everybody's channel, so go check it out. All the pet lovers up there, you're gonna like it. Either way, you're gonna like it, pet lovers or not. Show some love to him. Love you all, guys. Keep doing. I'm always there with support and love. With that being said, I'm done with it. So, put this light here on so I can just have some light over here. Then I put that on for a little to spice it up things. If I remember correctly, the last video I shot like this is a year ago, before the after the reunion with my kindergarten friends. Link in bio, go check that video out. Super fun video. So with that being said, signing off from Kutnadam Vlogs. See you next time with another vlog, another video. I hope I shared something valuable in this video. This is Maheshwaran. Peace.